So why would Hannibal Lecter make a better president than George Bush?
Well, everybody agrees we need a serial killer in the White House. I mean, the patriotic line is we're surrounded by enemies. Every continent except Antarctica is full of people armed to the teeth who hate us because they hate our freedom. I don't know what freedom we got that they could possibly hate. We don't have any freedom left in this fucking country. But they believe we got freedom and people hate us for it. So we need a serial killer in there to keep killing all these people who don't have any freedom and hate us for our freedom. On the other hand, the left-wing attitude is that these are all wars for oil or other natural resources. The government lies all the time, and what they're trying to do is rip off the rest of the planet. So we still need a serial killer in the right. So either from the left-wing or the right-wing perspective, we need somebody with the personality of a serial killer. So what type of serial killer do we want? I say Hannibal Lecter has a lot more culture, a lot more wit, a lot... George Bozo, as I call him, George Bush... Bozo, His Royal Fraudulency George II, he has about as much wit as a box of kitty litter. Hannibal Lecter is witty, educated, erudite, multilingual. He'd make a tremendously good impression on foreign leaders. And if he eats a couple of senators occasionally, well, hell, we could lose a couple of those geological specimens in the Senate and with no loss, with a great gain to the country. And so he ate the forebrain of a congressman once. So what do you need a forebrain for in Congress anyway? They all act from the back brain anyway. They don't need frontal lobes.
Mm-hmm. What was that something you said? Have you got a cup or something that says, forget all this self-improvement, I just want a good honest meal?
Oh, no, that's in the third volume. He said, damn well with self-improvement. I want a pleasant dinner. Another great saying, a lesbian patient of his who meets him after he's been in the nut house and escaped and has been at large for 10 years, they accidentally meet again. And she says, you know what I remember best? Was when I told you I was a lesbian and you said, there's nothing wrong with being weird, dear. You have no idea how weird I am. I never understood that until your trial. He must have been a great psychiatrist. I mean, speaking of fictitious characters, if he was real. No patient could bring in anything that he couldn't understand and appreciate.
What is your favorite sound?
The end of Beethoven's Ninth. Male and female voices singing together about joy and brotherhood and peace.
Do you think that the American government produces disinformation to make conspiracy theories seem absurd?
I don't think they're smart enough to do much of that. Maybe the CIA has one guy in one office who's in charge of confusing conspiracy theories by putting out false conspiracies. But I've seen enough of the conspiracy buff where they don't need that. They make up their own crazy theories to disgrace the research movement anyway.
Why are all the convicted felons, bar Oliver North, back in the administration from the Iran-Contra?
Well, like I said, we need that type since we got enemies on every continent. Either because they hate our freedom, as Bush says, or because they hate us for ripping off their land and their people and their natural resources and murdering them en masse. You know, 193 million people have been killed in wars since the end of World War II. That's the estimate of the World Game Center in Philadelphia. 193 million. That makes Hitler look like a piker. And most of these, you know, most of these were Bush wars, small wars. Most of them were the Western world against the Southern and Asiatic world, the Third World, trying to get out from under the control of the major banks in Hamburg, London, New York, Boston, etc. What I call the real DEA, the Dutch-English-American alliance between the royal families and the bankers. They're all interrelated to one another. You start getting into it, you find... Well, George Bush, for instance, is related to the Queen of England, is related to Prince Bernhard of the Netherlands, who's related to most of the major bankers. It's all one big happy family up there at the top.
So, What is, can you give a description of low cap, or what low cap is?
Oh, that's a term coined by Buckminster Fuller, a lawyer run capitalism. He thinks that the attempts to control capitalism by passing laws has turned control of the corporations over to their lawyers, whose job is to tell them how they can rob as much as they want without breaking a law technically. Or if they do break a law, what kind of defense to mount against any prosecutions? We think lawyers are really running the system. And considering the low opinion everybody has of lawyers, that's more terrifying than this. Any other conspiracy theory, like the Jewish conspiracy. Mm-hmm. I'm not afraid of Jews. All the Jews I know are very nice people. The Jesuit conspiracy, that's a little frightening, but there's a lot of good Jesuits, too. The Freemasonic conspiracy, every Freemason I know I like. But the idea of a lawyer conspiracy, that's really, those bastards are capable of anything. In law school, you got to learn how to argue both sides of any case, right? And that's very good education if you're going to be a philosopher, but it's not a good education for anybody who's going to have any power over other people. Mm-hmm. Because whatever they want to prove, they can prove it to themselves anyway. And they can make a pretty good argument to others, too, in most cases. That's what legal training is all about. No, my defendant did not set fire to the building. He was merely smoking in the hay. That wasn't a very good example, sorry.
Have you wrestled with the octopus lately? And how do you remember Princess Di?
What octopus?
The octopus.
Danny Casolaro's mm-hmm. octopus. I'm more worried about the SOG. It's this czarist occupation government. Now that we got an official czar, he's in charge of American medicine, but there's enough disputes going on in the other sciences that eventually the czar is going to be deciding all scientific questions the way he decides medical questions, according to public opinion poll. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the worst threat confronting us. I don't know how the hell we ended up with a czar. This country was supposed to free us from a king. Now we got a czar in place of a king. That's progress. That's not, I'd rather have the English king or queen back than have a goddamn czar settling scientific questions. And Princess Di, when she died, there was all a sentimentality about her. I said to my wife, what the hell did she ever do besides marry a rich man and take him for a lot of money in the divorce? You know, so she was leading the struggle against landmines. Like, okay, she did something for it. So I'm not against the Princess Di anymore. So she got a lot of money from a rich guy, and she did a lot of good, too. And she was a cute-looking woman, I must say. Besides, I liked her for dating an Arab. That shows a cosmopolitan spirit. That's why she got murdered, according to one conspiracy theory, you know. The British royal family didn't want her to marry an Arab because then the future King of England would have an Arab father mm-hmm. who might be related to Osama bin Laden, for all we know.